Hello, YouTubers. Thanks for stopping by the Dean Filmworks YouTube channel. So today we'll be looking at the Zoom F4 multi-track recorder. This is not a review, this is actually just an unboxing. I haven't had time to use the thing yet, and I'm actually recording this on the Tascam DR60D Mark II recorder. That's a mouthful, right? And I bought this at B&H Photo. They were the only ones at the time that actually had it in stock. They shipped it out to me very quickly, so I was very pleased with that. As a general disclaimer, I'm not a soundy or an audio person. I'm trying to learn more and more to get better quality with my own indie film works, which I think is the plight of most independent filmmakers, at least when they first start out. So I bought this thing, try to improve things. So let's just see about the unboxing and see what we end up with and how it goes. Thanks for joining us. Okay, so when you first see the box for the Zoom F4, you can clearly see it's got a nice outer sleeve that slid in with a couple little cool logos, a picture of the unit itself, and you know, just some normal things like the SKU and serial number and all that boring stuff. But once you pull off the sleeve under there, there's a really boring box. It just says F4 and nothing else on it. Nothing impressive there again. What would you imagine? We're not worried about the box though, are we? We want what's inside, and what's inside can change the landscape and the quality and production value of our films. Hopefully, let's see what we have here. Okay, so as you're unboxing it, quickly you see you have a adapter, AC adapter box right there on the right, and inside the box is the actual unit in this anti-static type protective sleeve. And the adapter is just a standard plug adapter, looks like 3.5 millimeter male AC wall adapter. I believe it's 12 volt. Kind of pull out the unit itself there. You can see it is made really well. It seems to be made of aluminum all the way around, top and everything. The only thing that's plastic is the face itself and the knobs, and it's actually a very durable feeling plastic. Now, really quick about these knobs, they're still small. I know they're bigger than the Zoom F8. I have not touched a Zoom F8 myself. I've seen the pictures, and one thing about the photos, when I'm holding it, it looks bigger in this video with my hands. I have big hands, but it's actually smaller physical size. The unit is smaller than I expected, and the knobs are, even considering when me having fat fingers, it would be hard to mix. I can't imagine trying to mix with this guy, because I don't know, if you're using the gain buttons, it's doubling them as a fader, it seems like it'd be tough. So the Zoom F8 would be damn near impossible for me. I don't know, it must take somebody really small fingers, maybe a female, to be able to turn those things, because when you look at that picture, you've got double the amount of knobs and they're even smaller than what the F4 has, so that could be a problem. So my suggestion is, with if you're going to mix, come out this ELF control mixer that works with the F4 and the F8. Matter of fact, it's made to go with it, and it adapts with the USB keyboard, so you can put in your metadata for your files. You've got the 8 sliders there, and with the master, again, I'm not soundy, so if I say something a little off, just forgive me and bear with me. On your gain knobs there, they're probably about the exact same size of what's on the F4, but maybe they're located out where you're not so close to unit, whether buttons in the close proximity, so it'd probably be a little more user-friendly. And definitely these faders, sliders would make that a lot more easy. And you can run your quarter-inch headphone jack right out of the bottom of that. It just feeds through the back from your field recorder unit into this and out the front. So that would be a highly suggested option to look into if you're going to do this. It retails for $349, which means that you're going to end up, if you buy the F4 and this, with $1,000 in your sound package, and you're supposed to get professional results. Truth is, I do know enough after watching the reviews and hearing other people's opinions on it, it's going to be marginally less than what you would get with sound devices, 633 or any of those 700, 600 series sound device field recorders, but it is a fraction of the cost. So cost always being a consideration for independent filmmaker. You can't really argue with the price difference of $650 versus $5,000, $6,000 for new to new unit comparison. So it's got the four XLRs, And they're high quality, they're snug fit. I had tried them a little bit after unboxing them. Maybe a little too snug sometimes. It's a little bit tough getting out some of the XLR adapters when you first get them in. You definitely have to give them a good yank. On the other side, it's got the two that are going out back to the camera or whatever you would, depending on how you run them in line. On the back, you have your battery compartment there, and within those are your two SDXC card slots, and you can hold about a terabyte worth of, up to a terabyte worth of cards with those two. I don't know why in the world you would need to hold that much, but you could. And it's got the expansion port for the little add-on where you can add a couple of XLR units and your time code, of course, your time code connectors. Then as you go deeper into the box, you can see it's got this DSLR mount where your camera can be mounted on top of the unit. You can take the screws off of this F4, screw this thing back on, and put your DSLR or some other small, I would say manageable size camera on top. You probably won't want to put something crazy weighted because this thing's, it's fairly strong, but I actually took it off and put it on my sound cart and screwed the screws down into this wood on the top of my sound cart to actually mount the system back onto my sound cart instead of doing the camera thing, because I do record separately with that. So that actually worked out quite well. And as you go through, you have typical manuals, adapter, you know, on the right, you have the 4-pin Hirose adapter, where it has a keeper there that just snaps together to hold the, I believe it's a 3.5 millimeter male standard AC type adapter that plugs into what you're seeing on the right. And this piece of paper you'll see is buy more of our stuff. Here's some of our stuff, buy it. That's what I get out of that. And some great products. Zoom does make great products for the money. So the manual, Here's the manual. It's quite long, looks like a lot of boring rubbish, but I'm sure it's quite important with the programming and everything. So far, initially, after having opened this and messed with it a little bit, I can say navigation's fairly straightforward. Some people are saying it's confusing, and wasn't so much, didn't seem that bad for me coming from a Tascam DR60D Mark II unit. It didn't seem that bad. Here is the cable keeper. It just snaps together, 4-pin Hirose. Sorry, I didn't get the clearest picture there. And you know, it's okay. Yep, there you go. It just goes right in there, 3.5 millimeter male, snaps and keeps it. So in closing, what I think about it, it's made very well on the outside, as good as you could expect, it's certainly for the money. The plastic feels high quality, the metal definitely feels high quality. The XLR in and out attachments and lines in and out are all very well made, feel very snug, feels like a good fit. Now in comparison, how does it compare with sound devices? I've never used sound devices, I'm not a soundie, but I've watched enough reviews and seen enough feedback where I can just tell you my initial opinion from what other people have said. When you look at these specs that I got between the Tascam DR60D Mark II, which is what this is actually being recorded on, versus the Zoom F4 and the sound device is 633. Here it is by the numbers. The noise floor, I mean, negative 81.9 decibels with the sound device is 633 coming in at negative 92.7 decibels. That's a pretty big jump, but so's that price. $649 versus $5,000-$6,000 from new to new units. That's not an argument for most indie filmmakers, seeing as we're survivalist when it comes to budget. And obviously, that's a no-brainer, unless you can get somebody in there that does have a sound device. You're gonna get marginally less quality, true. The gain is same across the board with these three units, plus 52 decibels of gain. It's kind of a no-brainer for the price. It's marginally, most people aren't probably going to know difference. From the reviews I've seen, I could tell a little bit of difference in some of them on the sound for sure, but it was so marginal, who cares unless you're functioning at the very professional highest level. I doubt you're going to have too many people ever say anything unless they're a real soundy audio person that's professionally trained, experienced, with some of you may be, but you've got to understand, apply the indie filmmaker. It's always got to be cost effectiveness, practical usage, and this wins. It's small, it's portable, it seems to work, and the price is right. That's the bottom line. If you get this with the mixer board that's made for it, the F-Control mixer, it's just a no-brainer. It's meant to work together in unison and give you professional sound for $1,000. If you buy the F4, you're going to be out a little more. You're going to be around 1450, 1500 with tax, probably US dollars on if you go with the F8 in that mixer. But you do have those options, and that's amazing to me. I think it seems to be a great product. I can't wait to use it and learn more about it. It's probably gonna take me a little while because I'm not gonna lie, I'm completely unfamiliar with this product. But so far, initial impressions unboxing, I think it's a win-win. The reviews are proving to be very promising. I do not think you'll be disappointed with this product. If you are, then pony on up that $6,000, $5,000, $6,000, or at least the $1,600 to $2,000 to buy you the sound devices used on eBay. You know, it's out there. If you want to spend that much more money, then my advice is spend the money to get what you want. And but you probably wouldn't need anything more than this for most projects, unless you're really going with a professional level budget and stuff, and then cost won't be a problem anyway. So yeah, thanks for watching. Please consider subscribing. And again, this is Dean Filmworks YouTube channel. Thanks for stopping by and have a good day.